Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I finally got my camera, so hopefully everything looks a lot better. I also kind of like redecorated the room because it was just like not matching the vibe. I actually need to get ready. We're gonna go thrifting because I asked you guys on my Instagram broadcast. I went a few days ago to try and vlog as well and it wasn't that like good. My lashes from Amazon finally came in today, so I'm really excited to try them. I am currently on a hunt for some new eyelashes because the original ones that I've been using, they stopped selling lashes and I'm like, girl, what the hell? What? First, we are going to be using my Mixoon Snail Mucin. You guys know, if you guys follow me on TikTok, Instagram, that I love this. I am on my third bottle now. I just feel like this serum literally is the best thing ever and it just makes me have like the perfect base for makeup without like pilling, you know what I mean? I just feel like a lot of the products I've been using lately have been causing a lot of pilling in my makeup. I never struggled from it before, but now it's like, I don't know what I'm doing wrong. Literally changed so many things. My foundations, my concealers. I do not use primers. I've also even switched like my lotions and everything and it just won't stop. So I don't know what it is. If you guys have any tips, please let me know down below. A girl is out here struggling. Now that I've done my skincare, we're gonna get on to the makeup. Look at my cute little bag. It's from Miniso. It's so dirty, excuse that. So we are going to be using the House Labs foundation. This passes the freaking vibe. This is one of the best foundations I've ever used. Like, it just sits so nice. It's so beautiful. This is another one of my favorites. This is the Unleashia Don't Touch Gloss Pink Cushion. I don't know why nobody talks about Unleashia, but like they should because their products are amazing. I really love this. I just wish they had more shades. And I think I actually have to go a shade darker than this. Please let me know if you guys like the vibes of me filming in the bedroom. If you guys watched like the vlogs before, like my room looks a lot different now. I'm still planning to add a lot more things to the room because it's a bit plain for my liking. Like, I want like a picture frame and I want more like lamps in my room. Why does this foundation look too light for me? I promise guys it's not this bad once I put it all the way on and my makeup is done. I've been trying out so many different foundations and I tried the Makeup by Mario foundation recently. It just would not stop peeling on me. Like, I tried so many things. I even bought primers, but maybe I'll try it one more time, see if I really like it. Like, I tried it like maybe 20 times at this point and I want to like it so bad, but it's just, it doesn't really fit my skin type. I feel like my forehead is literally always so much darker than the rest of my face. This Makeup by Mario brush though is so good to get in the crevices of your nose. I am going to get ready and I'll be right back. Okay, so I am finished with my hair and my makeup and my cute little outfit. I am in love with my hair today. I used this Wavy Talk thing today and at first I was having a little bit of a struggle using this. It's not as easy as everybody else says it is, but it works. It does the job. I'm already like so tired from just getting ready already. Home, I have to go pick up a package from my parents' house because it has like all these super freaking cute pink clothes that I ordered online. I haven't bought myself clothes in a long time because ever since I moved, I didn't even bring like all my entire like closet or anything because I realized that I just don't need a lot. I eventually will have to go home and declutter all of my clothes and get rid of like pretty much everything at that point. But I'm loving my new room. It's so cute. It's just white and pink. I already ate breakfast this morning before like I got ready as well. I need to add some finishing touches to the look, aka perfume, because a girl loves to smell good. A girl loves to smell good. I'm currently out of coconut water, which is so unfortunate. So yeah, I will get coconut water next week. But I drink coconut water like 24/7. Like, my bloodstream is literally just coconut water at this point. I'm gonna give you guys my perfume recommendations because they're just so good. First up is the Burberry Her like perfume. You should probably get the Elixir, to be honest, but I got this one as a gift for Christmas and I've been using it all the time. It's barely like even going down at this point and it just smells so freaking good. It just smells so sweet. So I am in love with this scent. This is my everyday scent. The Ariana Grande perfumes are so good. I love this one because it's so vanilla-y. Oh my god, also guys, my glasses. These are my old glasses. My cute glasses that I got like 2 years ago, they are breaking on me and causing a lot of pain like on my right ear. But yeah, let's get going. I forgot my freaking wallet today, so I'm not even sure if they take Apple Pay. My favorite place to look at like stuff for like the thrift is the lingerie section or the sleepwear section. I feel like they always have the cutest freaking things. These are so freaking cute. What the? Wait, because these are so freaking cute. But honestly, it's really hard to find good thrifting like pieces all the time. I just happen to get lucky here and there. My weak spot at thrift stores are definitely bags. Like, I have so many thrifted bags, and I found 3 Coach bags from the thrift that I love, and I feel like they're coming back. I think cheetah print is coming in, like coming back in. Like, there's no doubt about it because I've been seeing it everywhere. This is so freaking cute. What the fuck? I'm a tech Sandy. Luckily, that Savers actually takes Apple Pay. So I found these like cute little bloomers. They're just like little bloomer shorts, right? And they still have their tag on it, so they're freaking brand spanking new. And you've been seeing these everywhere. I feel like they're trending everywhere. And to find them at a thrift store for $4.79 is crazy. I can't wait to style these and wear them around and take pictures in it this summer because I think this will be so flippin' cute. I always find like the best jewelry at the thrift. Hopefully this is focusing. They're so pretty. They're purple. And yeah, these are so cute. They were only $2. Now on to this package. This is the Addicted package I was talking about that had like a whole bunch of like cute pink stuff that I ordered. I had to get a pink mini skirt. Oh my god, this is so freaking cute. They always have shorts under their skirts, which I enjoy very much. What is this? Why is it so wrinkled? I'm gonna have to steam this. So this is a bubble skirt. Looks like this. I got it in a size extra small. Oh my god, this bubble skirt does not have shorts, which is surprising. But a bubble skirt, it needs to be steamed. I've been kind of seeing these around, so I was like, okay, let me get a bubble skirt in white. For some reason, I feel like their quality has gone down since the last time I've ordered from them. This is what I was really excited for, was these wide-legged, like, yoga pants, basically. Again, the quality is not qualitying. You guys know I'm pretty big on quality. These are okay, like it's pretty heavy, but is it gonna last forever? Probably not. Usually the quality is so freaking good. I'm so confused what's going on here. Maybe it's just the stuff I ordered. Tube tops, I never expect them to be like really good quality ever, like ever. This one doesn't feel too bad at all, actually. It feels really, really soft, and they have the rubber in the inside so it doesn't like slip and fall, but it just has a bow and 2 bunnies, and I just feel like this would be so freaking cute to wear all the time. And then I got a like corset top like this, but it's pink. I bought this all with my own money, by the way. Another corset, but it's just white and it has straps. Let's try this bubble skirt first. We'll see if it looks cute or not. It might be a hit or miss, but it does need to be like steamed. But look at how cute this outfit is. Like, do we like the bubble skirt? If you guys are planning to get the same like skirt, make sure you guys order a size up because this is really like small. You would have to wear safety shorts under, but this makes me feel like a princess. I feel like a tulip. This is the next outfit. So freaking cute. I love it. This shirt literally sucks me in so freaking good. And the quality is not too bad on this. And then the skirt is a tad bit big, but it's okay because it sits like low-waisted on me like perfectly. So I don't really mind. Plus it has shorts under, so I feel very comfortable just like walking around. But I prefer shirts that kind of hit right here. I feel like it is the most flattering on my body type. So I've been trying to find some shirts that are a lot more long. Gosh, like this is still short to some people, but like can we get a little longer? Like, I like that this sucks me in. It's just so nice. The shirt is giving. It is so cute, and I cannot wait to wear this with like pretty much everything. The pants, they're okay. They're a little too like see-through. Like, if you don't wear the right underwear, people will be able to see everything.
Okay, how are we feeling about the earrings? I feel like they're super cute if I wore like a really classy type of outfit. I think I'm gonna end up studying all night because I am going to be taking my language arts like GED test soon. I just wanna be prepared for it. The only reason why I'm getting my GED is because I need a GED to get like certain certificates. I wanna see if there's anything else I really need to work on. I'm pretty good at like English in general. It was my best subject in high school.
Like, I want my Instagram and my YouTube channel and everything to be so much more girly and like pink and light and fun. I feel like now I can do that because I have my own space and I can just decorate how I want to. Canes or Chick-fil-A? You let me know. Why did I say it like that? Definitely let me know. Do you like Canes or do you like Chick-fil-A? Because personally, it's gonna be Chick-fil-A. Like, I just love Chick-fil-A chicken nuggets. Like, why is it so good? Good morning, you guys. So it is the next day and we are gonna go to Queenie and Pearl, which is a vintage shop that I love so much here in Minneapolis. We ended up hanging out until like 4 a.m. in the morning yesterday, which is freaking crazy. I did my lashes under my natural lashes today and I like these lashes so much better this way. I feel like it looks so good. So we're gonna go to Queenie and Pearl. We're getting so hungry, but Queenie and Pearl is literally down the street, so let's go see if they have any good vintage finds, because lately I've been seeing their Instagram and it's been really, really good. Oh, these are so freaking cute.
Those are actually so cute.
Oh my god, I love the I actually love their bowls that they sell. Like, I wore the white ones they sent me so much, and then I lost them, which I was like super sad about. Okay, we're gonna go upstairs to their vintage section. But she is so intrigued right now.
I'm looking at everything.
Right? Their stuff is so cute. But, girl, be prepared. It's so cute up here. Hey guys, we're currently eating Chick-fil-A because you guys know I like Chick-fil-A over Canes. So I am back home now. I didn't get to pick up anything at the vintage store like Queenie and Pearl because I just didn't see anything that caught my eye. When you are thrifting, it takes time. It takes a lot of dedication, to be honest. Like, you need to have time to go through all the racks and like really look at things. So I literally schedule a day to go. But those are my two main places that I do go if I'm looking for vintage or if I'm going thrifting. But if you guys do go to Queenie and Pearl, please let them know that I sent you there because their team is the sweetest freaking people. One of the girls was like, oh yeah, we still keep up with your TikToks. I'm like, purr, purr. Love that. Love that. Their team is so nice. I will see you guys in next week's video. Yeah? Yeah. Okay, bye.